Hi Leos, it's Cherry. I am here with a fun reading about your twin flame connection for the month of June. So I'm not sure if you saw my general reading for the collective, but it was a general twin flame reading for the month of June for the collective that you might like to watch first before you do this. It doesn't matter. Also, if you have any other placements in your chart other than Leo, you can look at the readings that I've already set out. So what I did with the general reading is I got this spread that's in my book. It's the Twin Flame spread, and what I'm going to do is kind of compare the Divine Masculine and Divine Feminine's different thoughts and feelings and hopes and actions and toward their twin flame in the month of June. And I'm gonna do this monthly, so this is now my second month in a row. So we've got on this side, I'm gonna designate for the masculine, divine masculine, this side, the divine feminine. Put yourself where you see yourself, male, female, masculine, feminine. I'm gonna use his and hers pronouns just for simplicity's sake, but definitely, you know, change that up in your mind if you want to. Also, if you don't identify with the term twin flame, you can exchange that for soulmate, beloved, counterpart, future spouse. If you see yourself as any kind of twin flame, like, or just like in the LGBTQ spectrum, like binary or something like that, you know, just see yourself in those contexts. If you are that kind of person, then you would have like the masculine and the feminine already integrated in one within yourself. So you can see this as like just a message for you, where you're two sides of yourself. However you want to look at this, it's for anybody who stumbles upon it. It doesn't have to be specifically for the twin flames out there, although that was my intention. My intention and my general intention is for twin flames, masculine he's and feminine she's out there, but put yourself where you see yourself. So let's begin. Okay. So for the masculine, I've decided to use the romance angels to get kind of a general vibe here for the month of June. And we have let go of control issues. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. So somebody, you know, masculines can be quite controlling. You know, they may have, you know, those kinds of issues where they want to be dominant, they want to show their strength, but showing their strength doesn't always translate into control. Actually, letting go of control is actually braver, right? Stronger. Let's see what the Divine Feminine's card is. What part of the journey is the Divine Feminine on in the month of June? All right, you got bonding. Very sweet. Bonding is saying as you get to know each other, you discover many things in common. So you two could also have control issues. And it's an interesting thing though that came up, because this is what happened to me, and I know it happens to a lot of the feminines out there, especially Leos who have strong pride in their, you know, in their personalities. So you could be seeing, and this is very common, you know, the masculine does do things sometimes that trigger us, that go against what seems right, what seems natural, what seems good to do. And so we see them as being in the wrong, or not growing, or not getting to that spiritual place. And we feel proud in ourselves for doing the work and getting to our spiritual place, and a little frustrated that the masculine hasn't leveled up and equaled our space. Well, I have learned, because I have pride issues too, I have learned that really and truly the masculine has been doing their work. It's just a little bit different than ours. It might be slightly more material and ours is more spiritual. We have, just because we're spiritual beings or more connected to spirit, the divine feminine still If we're still blaming or looking at the masculine as the bad guy or the villain in the case, then we still have our own issues that we have to deal with. So keep that in mind. I'm not blaming you. I'm just saying, I actually think that you're coming to these conclusions yourself. Like, you're keeping a very open mind about who this is, where he came from, what's happening with him, why he does what he does, why he reacts and maybe overreacts or whatever it is, and you're starting to grow a little bit of patience. Now, I know twin flame situations take a lot of patience, and sometimes you don't want to deal with it, and that's completely understandable. You're definitely allowed to walk away from it if you need a breather or whatever, but just know that the bond, the binds, the thread, the cord's always going to be there, and it is something that I feel like once you've met or acknowledge each other somehow, even if it's just, you know, in the 2D sense or 3D, in the 4D sense or 5D sense, it's important that you see it through somehow, at least in this lifetime, to the best of your abilities. So that being said, let's see what's going on for you guys in the month of June. So we're going to start with feelings first. So what are the Divine Masculine's feelings in the month of June towards his feminine for Leo's sun, moon, rising, or any other placement you might be interested in? Look, we have the Ten of Wands, which is very cute. This is about the burdens, but it's happy burdens. Like, this is what I'm taking on, but I want to take this on. Oh, look, and then you have the two tens, very nice, and the Ten of Pentacles. So here again, we could be dealing with a family man as well. Someone who's very attached to their situation, and sometimes I see the Ten of Pentacles as a very happy card, that a legacy, a future. This is this desire. He feels like he wants to have this future. He feels like he wants to plant this picture, this moment, and etch it in his mind forever. But I also sense that some of you out there might be dealing with a person who's already married, and it is their, you know, it's their duty and their job, but they might be with a karmic that's either toxic or they've you know, kind of run their course of their connection, and there's just nothing left there. But he could be hanging on for you know, the kid's sake or something like that. It seems like there's a familial situation that's trying to work out here. This could also be you and your person. You know, this could be your Divine Masculine and you, and maybe you have kids or something like that. So just, you know, put yourself where you see yourself. But I feel that in the bigger picture, it's a good thing. You know, first of all, the very most important thing to know is this masculine here is very loving and caring about his, you know, like anything that's put in his charge. So whether he has children or not, it's important to him to take care of his duties and to take care of things. And these are such beautiful cards that he may also be feeling like he wants to take care of you and make a family with you, and it would be an honor to have this future with you. The only reason why I see that this relating to this, and there's could be a third party, but maybe not at all, you know. Maybe also there could be discussions about family, and he's being stubborn or trying to control the situation, and spirit is suggesting for the masculine to allow the situation to just unfold and not to put too much stress or anxiety behind it. It will resolve itself. So anyway, but the fact that he's very noble, and has a high sense of integrity and diligence and duty and towards family and love towards you and any, you know, towards his divine feminine. Anyway, very nice for feelings. He's feeling very, you know, duty bound to the people he loves. There you go. All right. So what is the divine feminine feeling towards her divine masculine in the month of June. For Leo's sun, moon, and rising. So what is the divine feminine feeling here? Oh, did that one want to come out? That's good. We've got the Eight of Wands. So she's feeling like she definitely wants to communicate, get in touch. She wants to start this now. She doesn't want to wait anymore. She's feeling proactive and action-oriented. And maybe she wants to travel. Maybe she wants to be impulsive and make a split-second decision and do something at the last minute, unexpected, you know. But, you know, Spirit is saying there is a chance that if there's a moment that comes up that arises that feels very serendipitous to the feminine here, there is a positive resolution, a positive things are happening, and good news will happen. So feminine, if you're feeling this way, that's good. Stick with that good energy, because I feel like good news is coming out of this situation. This situation will evolve naturally and resolve itself. Okay, now let's see what the divine masculine is thinking towards his divine feminine in the month of June. For Leo, sun, moon, rising. Very nice. We have the Six of Cups. So more loving child energy too. And Six of Cups is definitely about the nostalgia and feeling very tight and connected with his divine feminine. The masculine here really has decided, thinking that I want to truly communicate with my feminine. Tell her my true feelings here, my true thoughts, but you know, there are words that he would like to say, but he's hoping more than anything, and this could be in the hopes category too. He's thinking to himself, by action she will know, by my actions, and then she will know my intentions and my feelings in this situation. And he's thinking, he's just thinking, the things that I do, she will know what I'm intending, what my intentions are, you know? So watch out for his actions. And also watch out this side for when action comes and see what that has to say. So what is the divine feminine thinking towards her divine masculine in the month of June for Cancer, sun, moon, rising, and other placements? Ooh, the divine feminine is thinking, wow, Nine of Wands. You also got the Ten of Pentacles too. So the Ten of Pentacles came out for both of you. You were definitely on the same wavelength. You know, your idea of Ten of Pentacles might be slightly different from your masculine's. The masculine here is thinking, this could be a moment in time. This could be fleeting, but it could be something that lasts forever. You know, that's what that's part of their hopes as well. And they're definitely their feelings. The feminine here is feeling, or is thinking that these are my people, you know. This is spiritual and material abundance, and this is your community, and this is your generosity and wealth and prosperity, and also building a legacy. But it's like and there's kids here too. It's like, su casa es mi casa, your kids are my kids, you know, we're all in this together, we're all one, you know, we're a community, we're a big happy family, and not just you and me and with our families, but also you and me with the world, you know, the way we connect with the world. So that's really beautiful. And the Nine of Wands is just beautiful energy too as well. It's very optimistic, very very ready to tackle the world, determination and resilience. And it's ready, it's like that final push, ready for what's next to come, finding the motivation. The key phrase here is, I push beyond my own perceived limitations and I remain open and trusting as I do. So you know, whatever, you know, whatever. I think this is like the divine feminine saying, I am not slipping into lack mentality. I am sticking with no matter what happens over here, you know, I mean, but it's all good. Like the only cautious card was this one, and it wasn't really cautious. It's just there could be extenuating circumstances here, right? But there is definitely a lot of love and a lot of desire to this. I feel a lot, you know, family here too, you know, like wanting to meld families, whether it's, whether you guys have, you know, either side has children, whether there's parents, older people, you know, just important people in each other's lives, brothers and sisters and parents and things like that. All of that come into play when you are desiring to move, to level up, to go to that next step. So I feel that's really good news here. So let's see what are the Divine Masculine's hopes towards or for the relationship in the month of June. Leo. All right, so the hopes here get a little sexy. The hopes here, I feel like the hopes here are that, so the Knight of Pentacles is action, right? It's movement. The Pentacles means money and stability. In this case, we have kind of like a mini devil come out. So money in abundance is great, but money, material wealth is not more important than emotional and spiritual wealth. But he's hoping, maybe he's hoping that the Divine Feminine will give him at least some of this kind of attention, or will accept his gifts, or will see, you know, will. So there should not be some kind of exchange, right? Favors, exchange for favors. But, and that's where the communication gets tricky. So he, so maybe part of this is his hope right here is that he can communicate his desires, that she doesn't see him as a tempting devil, but that she sees him as a person who just is eager to be giving. That's what his intentions are. And so, but it's important that both sides stay out of that imbalance area, you know. Maybe he does, the masculine doesn't need to tempt his feminine to his world. All he has to do is be his authentic self, and he will get what is he wants. But he feels like he might have to tempt her somehow, or prove somehow that if she chooses him, or she chooses to come to his world or come towards him, that she will get rewarded somehow. So it's kind of a weird kind of energy that it's almost like a miscommunication, what he's trying to say and his actions. So right, actions speak louder than words. So he has trouble with the words, right? He's already said, he said, I am a gift giver. So my love language is gift giving, for one. My love language is also acts of service, but I'm really kind of have trouble with the communication, the words of affirmation. They don't, my words don't always come out right. So maybe he's hoping you see that his gifts mean more than what sometimes it appears on the surface. I think that might be it here. He's a wealthy man, you know. He has this, and he doesn't want you to get the wrong idea that he's trying to buy you, maybe. Maybe he's afraid that you think that of him. Okay, so let's see what... yeah, so he's hoping that you see him as pure intentions. So what are her hopes in this situation between the... she and her masculine in the month of June? Her hopes here. She also has the Ten of Wands coming out too. And she's got the High Priestess. So she's also hoping that he sees her as this spiritual person and somebody that's keeping secrets, but important secrets, secrets about the twin flame connection and spiritual matters and the subconscious and all things that are meant to stay in the spiritual realm close to her heart. She's not bragging or making a big announcement about it and not putting it out in the public. You know, if he's gonna give her gifts, she wouldn't show him off. She wouldn't say something about them. That's kind of what I'm seeing a little bit here. And she's also hoping that he understands. She knows this journey is you know, this journey for them is a long journey. It is also at its final push. I feel like they're both seeing it almost there, like they're almost there. it's the final push, it's the determination, it's the end results, it's getting to, you know, it's climbing that hill, no matter how hard it is, it's getting there. She's hoping that he doesn't take on too much responsibility or too much burden. She wants him to set down the burdens that don't belong to him, and prioritize. But she does also understand his duties as well. Okay, good. So let's see what action will the Divine Masculine take towards his feminine in the month of June. Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising. Oh, nice. So we've got the King of Swords. King of Swords is bold. He is all about mental energy. He's intelligence. And with the King here, I feel like this is, he could be writing her, you know, maybe he realizes he has, you know, issues with communication. So he's decided, I'm going to write things down. You know, I'm just going to brainstorm things. Maybe I'll write you a beautiful letter. He's going to write something down. So this is intellectual maturity. Also, he could be writing down a strategy, you know, or he could be getting more education. He could be finding ways or he's working on his book or something like that. But if it's towards the feminine or towards the relationship, then it's this communication. So I feel like he is balancing a lot of things. It is this need to control the situation is falling away, and he's like really learning who he is and what his needs are. He's learning about his love languages. He's learning about his issues with communication. He's working on those kinds of things. He's working on this temptation thing and seeing how it's coming across a certain way. And he's working on being direct and more authentic to who he really is, so that communication can flow better between the two parties here in the best way possible going to the future. So that's really good. I think learning how to communicate is so important, and it's a lot of growth and a lot of learning here. So let's see. The journey is, you know, you're in your final stretch. You're both working very hard, and she's fine with that. She's getting to know him through the lessons that he's learning for himself, and that's beautiful. So let's see what her actions will be in the month of June towards her Divine Masculine. Very nice. So we got the Page of Pentacles. So she too has, she might have gifts, maybe her gift to him is receiving his gifts, you know? So if he likes to give gifts, then she is receiving it with grace, and she's receiving it with this knowledge too, that it comes from a pure place. This is also, this represents the peace of abundance and this feeling of safety and calmness and peace and creating opportunities for more for great things to come. So she's, I think she's very mature here, very accepting. She's in the right mindset. She's in the right spiritual place too, to allow. He's only just the slightest bit step slower than her, but they're definitely on the same road, on the same path, you know, and she sees how he's growing, and she is also growing. She has her growth to do as well, but it's just a little bit different, you know. It's the Nine of Wands is kind of more of it's not being so defensive about things all the time, and seeing the bigger picture, you know, not like overreacting to small things, but seeing the bigger picture, and using her intuition when it comes to dealing with this connection. So it's really, I think it's very good. I think they're in a really nice place together. I mean, it's not, I don't see necessarily a move towards union or reunion necessarily, but I definitely see a move towards an immense opening up of communication here. All right, so let's see what the charms have to say. Let's put this guy. All right, let's see. So this is, by the way, our Leo by Deja drew it. And you can see the little Leo symbol here. And it's, I am authentic. So yeah, that's definitely, this is definitely what he's learning. This last action card is all about learning their authentic, the authentic them, instead of being manipulative, because control has to do with manipulation. They're learning not to do that anymore. All right, let's give a little gibble. All right, you have a kiss here. Feeling brave, something very sweet going to pass between the two of you. You could meet up for a kiss, maybe. You've got the Three here, and kisses are a lot like communication, you know. Maybe you're dreaming of a kiss. When you dream of a kiss, that means your communication is going to be very good in the waking life. You have the number Three and the K, and sea mermaids represent deep, sweet communication and also beauty. So the feminine here is all full of beauty and intelligent and deep communication. And the puppy dog is all about soulmates and best friends and honesty and trust and loyalty and devotion. And I feel like this is, you know, unconditional love, and so he's tapping into this authentic kind of love, you know, this being more of who he is instead of trying to manipulate and control things to his fashion without him having to show any of who he is, you know. So I definitely see that happening here. Okay, so that's really nice. I hope you like that, you guys. If there's anything you need, just check out the description box, and please subscribe if you're new, and if you're returning, thank you so much. I'm gonna keep on with the rest of the readings. Definitely check out other readings for the other signs in your astrological chart, and I'll see you next reading. Faith, trust, and pixie dust.